Brother Mike Watford, when you became a member of our fraternity at the University of Florida, you became part of an extended family. Growing up in a military family that moved frequently made it hard for you to maintain long-lasting friendships. So it was important for you to find a way to make camaraderie and brotherhood part of your college experience, and you found it at SigEp. Finding support among your brothers really gave you a solid foundation that carried you through college and helped you establish your very successful career. In addition to being involved in the fraternity, you served as treasurer of the Interfraternity Council for a year and worked two part-time jobs most of your time in college. You made the most of those years, learning how to prioritize responsibilities so you could work, participate in Greek life, and attend Saturday afternoon football games that you enjoyed so much. Yet you still performed exceptionally well in the classroom. Long before SigEp launched the Balanced Man program, you were impressing everyone around you with how well you balanced school, work, and your social life. When you graduated, you were presented with the Male Leadership Award. Having earned a bachelor's degree in finance, you moved to New Orleans for a job with Shell Oil's upstream exploration and production business. It was during this time that you began taking night classes at the University of New Orleans to earn an MBA while continuing to work at Shell. Once again, you were demonstrating what it meant to be a balanced man. By the time you left the company, you had gained a wealth of experience, and you were ready to transition from being an individual contributor to managing others. Over the course of your more than 40-year career, you've held management positions in natural gas, exploration, production, finance, and marketing at a number of energy companies, including Superior Oil, Meridian Oil, and Torch Energy. You drew on this wide range of experience when you were named CEO of Nuevo Energy in 1994. Just a few years is all it took for you to grow that company from $200 million to over $1 billion in valuation. And then in 1999, you were tapped to helm natural gas company Ultra Petroleum, which you led until your retirement last year. You've been one of the leading contributors to the development of the industry, serving as a member of the National Petroleum Council, twice as chairman of the Independent Petroleum Association in America. And in addition, you served on the boards of Bellwether Exploration, America's Natural Gas Alliance, Southern Mineral Corp, and many other organizations. But for you, success is not just a measure of your professional achievements. You are a longtime donor of your cherished Florida Alpha chapter, and you support various community organizations in and around Houston, where you now reside. Be it through building children's homes, stocking food pantries, or funding scholarships, you are committed to helping those in need. And as you stated, I am a firm believer that once you have been blessed with success, you need to give back. Brother Watford, other great leaders agree. It is said that a man builds a life. A man makes a living by what he gets. A man builds a life by what he gives. You have given a lot, and you have built a great life, Brother Watford. And you've helped many others build better lives too. Today, for a change, we would like to give something to you. In honor of your many achievements, both in the past and ongoing, today we'd like to present you the SigEp Citation.
So thank you. Let me back us up a little bit. I am a little taller. John, I don't know what to do because gator bait is what you are. And you cannot imagine what the lines I'm going to have tonight at our little cocktail gathering before dinner about a C student being president of Florida State University. Now, I'll give you some red meat here in just a moment, so we'll make it even. So thank you all very much. I appreciate the award. Again, unlike John, I got to take my glasses off to read. The opposite problem. I was asked to appear in Orlando 2 years ago to get this award, and I had a conflict. I had a daughter who was pregnant, her due date was around that time, and she lived in Abu Dhabi, so I had to pass on that. So as a result, they invited me back this year. They said, you gotta be the last one, Mike, and you gotta be quick. Brevity is the key, and you're limited to one side of one piece of paper for your comments. So here we go. It's five. Corey helped time me earlier. It's 5.5 minutes. So let's get through it and let everybody go do something else. So I'll be serious for a moment or two. And you're going to find that my comments are much more narrow and really have to do with a life experience. Sometimes the biggest advantage in life is being born with no advantage. It's up to you and the environment around you to mold you into someone. Hopefully with values, a sense of purpose, work ethic, maybe even a sense of humor. I think we've seen that on display already. That's what this organization did for me at a tender age. I came to the University of Florida, a young 17-year-old, immature, certainly not worldly, did not know anyone, and a bit lost. I found a sense of community, a place to be, a group to be with, traditions, and a helping, caring culture beneath the rough-hewn exterior. And it was a very rough-hewn exterior in the early 70s. This organization, well, it led to a balanced college life, or a more balanced college life for me. I think today the vocabulary is the balanced man. You're all familiar with that. This organization helped lay a solid foundation for my life's journey. I left 4 years later, much more mature, had a very good job, a fiance, school debt, yes, you even borrowed money back then, and having enjoyed both good and bad experiences. That was 1975, I was 21 years old. Today's 2019, I'm 65 years old, so that's 4 decades and 4 years later. I've actually learned a few things along the way, and I'd like to briefly share one perspective today which I think you're gonna find unique. And it has to do with the old adage of turning lemons into lemonade, and how that was applied to my career. And obviously I did okay, or I wouldn't be up here today, of course, unless the selection process is flawed for this award, as someone else said earlier, and that could be. I went to work right out of college, right out of the University of Florida, for Big Oil. And I ended up working for 6 different companies in my professional career. And all of those job changes weren't voluntary. Companies were acquired, divested, there was politics going on, and other items. So what I want to very briefly focus on is what can be the benefits of losing your job. Right, losing your job. That's what we're talking about. Normally that is perceived as a strong negative, not a blessing. But here's where the lemonade was made in my story. Anyone's first job loss is devastating regardless as to the reason. But it does create the need to seek other opportunities in a very rigorous, not casual fashion. Most of us in that situation broaden our horizon, and some of us begin to look at the risk-reward of opportunities differently. At least I did. It's hard to be successful without suffering some sense of failure. Often the suffering is much less than advertised, which again goes back to the risk portion of the equation. What I discovered was to be less fearful of the downside, risk of future job loss, and more captivated by the upside, the reward. So I started working my way down the food chain in terms of company size. I went from Big Oil to Medium Oil to Small Oil. I also went from the downstream part of the business to the upstream, which just simply means I greatly expanded the breadth of my experience. I went from big bureaucracies where there was little upside to taking risks, no upside taking risks, to more nimble entrepreneurial organizations where effective risk-taking was rewarded. I went from jobs where all your compensation was salary to jobs where the smallest portion of your compensation was salary. The upside being cash bonuses and equity, stock. I think most of us in this room understand that wealth is largely created through concentrated equity positions. So the lemons of losing my job several times caused me to re-examine the risk-reward of a broader opportunity set, which I never would have done absent the job losses. I would have stayed in my lane. I would have provided a very comfortable life for my family and myself. And my lemonade is that I got to be the CEO of two separate companies for combined 22 and a half years, getting to truly run companies, raising billions of dollars in Wall Street, investing billions of dollars. And over that time period, I ended up on the Forbes list of highest paid CEOs in 2011. And I was good, not great, probably like John is at Florida State University. I learned to not make achieving perfect the enemy of the good. And I hope that if you are served lemons in your future, you have the opportunity to turn those into sweet tasting lemonade like I did. Thank you very much.